In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Windows Server 2022, and then we'll go on and perform some initial configuration tasks to give you a feel for Windows Server 2022 and what it's all about. Now, before we get started, if you find this video helpful, please help the video by giving it a like, share it, and subscribe to the IT Taster channel for more content. So with that said, let's get into the video. Okay, the first thing I want to do is download an evaluation copy of Windows Server 2022, which I can do for free from the Microsoft Evaluation Center. There it is, Windows Server 2022 evaluation. And I'm going to follow the link to the Microsoft Evaluation Center. There it is, Windows Server 2022, and we can evaluate it for 180 days. I'm going to choose to download the ISO file because that's going to give me the option to either boot from it in a virtual environment or create physical installation media if I'm installing on physical hardware. It's also worth taking the time to have a look through these sections here. There's further information and also some useful resources there as well. Click continue. And then it's simply a case of just filling in the form and then clicking continue to download Windows Server. Now, do bear in mind that the ISO file is around about 5.4 gigabytes in size, so it may take a little while depending on the speed of your internet connection. Now, before I begin installing the Windows Server, I just want to quickly talk about hardware requirements for Windows Server 2022. Now, the first thing to bear in mind is that it's unrealistic to provide recommended hardware requirements because of the different roles that a Windows Server can be deployed in. For example, the hardware requirements of a file server will be very different to those of a virtual host running Microsoft Hyper-V server and hosting lots of virtual machines. So one of the things that Microsoft suggests is to conduct test deployments to help determine your hardware spec. Now, one of the things that you'll find listed on the Evaluation Center website are minimum hardware requirements for Windows Server 2022. But do bear in mind that they're an absolute minimum. A machine which is of minimum spec hardware will be very, very slow, and it's not something that I would use in the lab, and I certainly wouldn't consider it in a production environment. And finally, the ISO file that we download is 5.4 gigabytes in size. Now that's okay if we plan to install directly from it, if we're running a virtualized setup within the lab. But if we have a physical server and we need to create physical installation media, this is going to be too large for a conventional DVD, so you'll need to consider creating something like a bootable USB memory stick. This is the lab setup that I'm going to be using for this video. I'm running VirtualBox. I've configured a virtual machine with 4 gig of RAM, 2 CPUs, and 50 gigabytes of storage. Now, I am being fairly conservative here with my resources, so do bear in mind, this is just for the lab. It's not something that I would suggest using in a production environment. Now, once I've installed Windows Server 2022, I'm going to move on and perform some initial configuration tasks, including setting the hostname server 1 and giving the server an IP address of 192.168.1.101. It'll have a default Class C subnet mask. I'm going to configure a default gateway and DNS. So with that said, let's go over to the lab and begin the installation. Okay, my virtual machine is just starting up and I'm booting from the Windows Server 2022 ISO file. I need to select my time and currency format and click next and click install now. I need to select the operating system I want to install. You'll notice I have Windows Server Standard Evaluation and also Data Center. Now you'll notice that two of them have desktop experience next to them. Let's move that across a little bit. Desktop experience is the GUI version with a graphical interface, and the versions without it are Server Core. That is pretty much a command line driven version of Windows Server, which you largely use PowerShell to configure and administer. So for my evaluation, I'm going to choose Windows Server 2022 Standard and with the desktop experience and click next. I need to accept the license agreement, reading through it, of course, and checking the box and click next. I need to select custom install. This is a brand new install. We can upgrade a previous version, but I'm no fan of in-place upgrades. It's not something that I would recommend, so I'm going to choose custom. And here I'm going to partition my disk space. Now for my evaluation, I've only got 50 gigabytes available. So I'm going to make that slightly smaller just so that I've got a tiny area available to create an extended partition, which we may use in later videos. So I'm just going to change that slightly to something like, we'll go with 49 gig. Click apply. And click next. Now it's going to take a little while the installation copies the files across. So I am going to speed the video up to save you hanging around, but don't worry, I'm not going to miss out any important bits. And then we'll rejoin the video a little later on. The installation files are just finishing up. And once that's done, the server will reboot a couple of times. And then after that, we can begin our initial configuration. Server's rebooted, so now I need to assign an administrator password. And click finish. So I'm going to log into the server with my password. Server Manager will start by default. It always does with Windows Server. Just going to get rid of that. And I'm also going to hide the configure this local server tile. Now don't worry if you see some services highlighted in red. This can typically be some services that are delayed starting up, especially in a lab environment and from an initial install. So next thing I'm going to do is click on local server. And as you can see at the moment under Ethernet, our server is obtaining an IP version 4 address from DHCP. So because this is a server, I want to assign it a static IP address. So click that. I'm going to our Ethernet adapter properties. And I'm going to be working with IP version 4 in this video. So we're going to IP version 4. And I'm going to use the following IP address of 192.168.1.101. This is because it's an address that fits in quite nicely with my router in my lab. If you tab down, automatically the subnet mask of 255.255.255.0, class C subnet mask is put in there automatically. I'm going to assign a default gateway in my router, which is 192.168.1.254. And for the time being, I'm also going to use my router as my DNS server, 192.168.1.254. And click OK. Okay, I'm just going to scroll across and just quickly check that my evaluation has been activated, which it has. And the next thing I'm going to do is enable remote desktop, because that's quite useful for managing my server. So I'm going to click allow remote desktop connections to this computer. And remote desktop firewall exception will be enabled if we click this, which is what we want. Click OK. Now it will still show as disabled. It's necessary to refresh the dashboard. And as you can see, that now changes to enabled. Now the next thing I want to do is assign my server a host name. new computer name, because as you can see, Win-N6CU6G7T2S2 doesn't exactly roll off the tongue and it's not very easy to work with. So we just need to click that, click change, and I'm going to call my server one. And before I click OK, by the way, just notice that we're in a work group at this stage. Let's click OK. And we're prompted to restart the server to apply these changes. So I'm just going to quickly do that. And we'll rejoin the video once the restart is complete. Okay, the server's rebooted. I'm back in Server Manager, but you'll notice we've got a few more issues with services there. So I'm just going to hit refresh. And most of those have gone away. If you do want to determine any services that haven't started up properly, if there's an issue, just go into the service and we can see there that it's the Microsoft Edge Update service and it's set to automatic delayed start. So one of the things we can actually do is just start service manually. It should start up in a couple of seconds. Now we just do a quick refresh. There we are, and everything's all looking nice and green, nice and tidy. If I click on local server, we can now see that the computer name is server one, our work group there, and our IP address of 192.168.1.101. Now notice that my clock's a little bit out, so I'm just going to set that. So we'll adjust the date and time. Okay, I'm just going to check my time zone because that's not correct. There we are. And I'm just going to choose sync now. Okay, now my time's correct. And the last thing I'm going to do is go to Windows Update. And we'll check for updates. Now, even though this is an evaluation, it is well worth installing Windows updates just to make sure that everything works correctly and there aren't any issues that may interfere with your evaluation and your configuration. Now, this is going to take a little while, so I'm going to leave that running in the background. So we've installed Windows Server 2022 and we've performed some initial config. Now, it really is important to perform some of these initial config tasks at this stage. It may seem very simple, setting things like host names and IP addresses, but it's really important because when we install roles later on in the series, like Active Directory and make our server a domain controller, we don't want to go back and change things like host names and IP addresses. It gets messy and can cause problems further down the line. Now, if you found this video helpful, please help the video, give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the IT Taster channel for new content if you haven't already. So, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.